Welcome back. Well, it is a bill almost every American pays. That is the water bill. The latest numbers show Americans consume 322 billion gallons of water every day. American Water is the largest investor-owned water and waste utility company in the United States. Joining us right now in a First on Fox Business interview is the American Water CEO and president, Susan Story. It's great to see you, Susan. Thanks so
Thank
much for
you,
joining
Brian.
Us. Where does the story stand today in terms of the supply-demand on water?
That's a great question. So water, as you said, is the most critical resource that every family, every person in the U.S. needs. There are three basic policy issues that the United States is wrestling with. One is water supply. We're all very familiar with the droughts in California, Texas, and parts of other states. The second is water quality, the issue of emerging contaminants. We've all heard about the PFAS and the PFOAs and Legionella and the lead issue in Flint, Michigan. And the third, though, that doesn't get as much play is the water infrastructure, which is 44% of all U.S. water infrastructure is near the end of life or failing, and within the next 10 years will be out of life.
Wow.
And going to your Investor Day presentation, you talked about how you're going to invest $7.3 billion over the next 5 years. Where is that capital going to be deployed?
So we have regulated utility operations in 16 states. New Jersey and Pennsylvania are our biggest states, and our largest seven states account for 88%. We are basically replacing old pipe. In the United States, we lose 2 trillion gallons of treated water every year, over 20% that we have treated, we put in pipes, and it just leaks. We've got to find a way to save that water, reduce costs, and you do that by replacing infrastructure with smarter infrastructure.
Susan, where does climate change rank among the list of concerns that you've got as an executive and issues that you're responding to?
Part of the big infrastructure replacement includes resiliency of our assets. For example, in New Jersey and Pennsylvania, in the past 6 to 7 years, we've had 4 or 5 events that exceeded the 100-year flood. Tropical Storm Irene that dumped a lot of water, almost took out water facilities, treatment facilities in New Jersey. So we're spending about 8% of that capital spend on resiliency projects to address issues of changing
climate. So is it, in your mind, is it a real issue? Is it a real problem that you have to address and respond to?
Obviously, there's a debate about this.
Right. So for American Water, we don't get in the debate about why the climate is changing, whether it's natural forces, man-made. What we're looking at is we look at 10, 20, 30 years of data. We look at what we need to build our assets for to be resilient and hardened, and that's our main concern.
What about drought? Is that one of the issues?
Absolutely. We serve in California. It is one of our top 7 states. So we were part of the conservation efforts that went on, offering incentives for conservation. We actually saw in our service territory 2 years ago usage of water declining 20 to 25% as a result of conservation efforts.
What about the investment, whether it's individuals or investment funds that are making big investments in water? The Wall Street Journal had an article recently that the Harvard Endowment has been quietly going out and buying California vineyards with the water attached, with the water underneath, as a bet on climate change.
Absolutely. And so that goes back to the water supply, and especially in California, where you have water rights and there is an order to which people have the rights to the water, buying those water rights or properties that have those rights is very important. From an investment standpoint, as an investor-owned utility, however, we raise most of our own capital. We're A credit rated by S&P. Now, I will tell you that the WIFIA that EPA just passed, they did allow private companies to participate, and only 2 private companies were the recipients of the 39 projects, and we were one of those companies, and 2 of our projects in Missouri will qualify, which will result in us being able to get that money at the Treasury rates, the 30-year fix.
So what about these new rules? Because the Trump administration announcing new changes to water rules yesterday. The new proposal will redefine the waters protected under the Obama-era Clean Water Act. In terms of implications, how does this change your business?
You know, actually, from my understanding, it won't change our implications very much, and let me tell you why. So our water sources, about 140 across the United States, are main navigable waterways. So anything, any river that goes into those navigable waterways, the wetlands that maybe are adjacent to those are our main areas of concern for surface water. My understanding is that even with the changes, that those will still be covered and that everything else will be a state issue. We not only work with the federal government, but we work with states based on the individual challenges to ensure that our water has the best quality, that it's safe for drinking.
And what about the quality of water today?
So
what would you say about it?
One of the things that I'm concerned, in the United States, water is very disaggregated. There are over 50,000 providers of water, predominantly utilities or municipalities, and most of those have 3,000 to 5,000 connections and staffs of 5, 10, 15 people. They're very good, but for example, our company, we have an R&D group with 15 scientists, and we have 5 scientists, including PhDs, who their only work is emerging contaminants. So we're out there saying, what is the next thing that can make a headline that may not be regulated by the EPA? But we work with the Centers for Disease Control. We partner with the EPA to look at not just what's regulated today, but what are those emerging contaminants that could have effect on drinking water and pause a concern or create a concern.
Is your strategy to roll up all these disaggregated companies into one big giant business?
So to be clear, the majority are municipalities, city-provided systems, and we think cities should have optionality. So we don't think anyone should be forced to do anything. But where we can provide better water quality, better standards, and those cities today, municipalities, they have so many priorities: fire protection, police, pensions. We think we can offer solutions to those assets that that's all we do is water and wastewater.
Really fascinating. It's a story that you don't focus on enough, and it's so important to us all. Susan, great to see you.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. Susan's story there.